Hey everybody, it's Wendy. Welcome. I'm so excited you're here with me today. We are going to be using the Bonanza Buddies stamp set and dies. This is a bundle that's going to be available on January 3rd, 2020. This is from the new mini catalog. We're going to use these two dies specifically. I'm also using a little bit of the designer series paper today from this bundle or suite of products. It's really beautiful. All the designer series paper in the collection is gorgeous. I've got my 2-inch circle punch, smoky slate, ink, and Bermuda Bay. And I've got Whisper White cardstock, and I just went ahead and punched that 2-inch circle out so I would just have it. And then we're gonna go ahead and do our stamping. I'm going to stamp this adorable koala bear on a piece of Whisper White cardstock. And then I'm going to stamp his nose and eyes with Memento Tuxedo Black ink. And they are in the package because I didn't realize they weren't on there. So that's kind of cool that they're a separate stamp. Will allow you to do different colors and different things with it. So I'm going to go ahead and stamp that down. It's a little difficult for me to line it up when on camera, because I naturally want to put my head right over the top. But this koala bear just kind of looks like he's looking off to the side instead of straight ahead. and then I've got Bermuda Bay ink, and I'm going to stamp my sentiment with Bermuda Bay and have it ready to go. And I stamp it a little whomperjawed there, so I went ahead and re-stamped it. Okay. And I have kind of something exciting to tell you. So all the products that I'm using today are linked below the video, but you can't purchase the Bonanza Buddy bundle or the designer series paper till January 3rd. So you can just add those to your wish list. If you got a catalog from me, you also got a wish list. FYI, there's a little typo in my catalog letter. Whoops, I found that out today after I mailed them all. The exciting thing is the instructions for this are in the description below. There's a link to my blog. So it says blog post with instructions. You click on that and it's going to take you there. I converted it to centimeters. So if you are in the UK basically anywhere else in the world besides America, you would use centimeters. And the cool thing about this paper trimmer from Stampin' Up! Is that it has the inches and centimeters. So I thought to myself, why not start including centimeters on projects? So I'm going to try it. If you live in one of those areas and you would like to make this and get back to me and let me know if I did it correctly, I would appreciate that. This is Bermuda Bay cardstock, and it's cut at 3.5 inches by 4 3/4, or 12.1 centimeters by 9 centimeters. And I scored it on the 4 3/4 inch side, or the 12.1 side, at 2 inches and 2 3/4 inches, or 5.1 centimeters and 7 centimeters. Then I turned it to 3.5 inch side, and I've scored it at 3 3/4 of an inch. So 3/4 of an inch, or 1.9 centimeters, and 2 3/4 inches, or 7 centimeters. So I hope you guys got all of that, and I hope that's not too complicated. But if you need the instructions written out, they are over on my blog. Okay, I'm folding on all the score lines. You saw that I trimmed in on those little bitty tab areas, and then I'm going to use tear and tape adhesive to create the box to put it together. I always recommend using a heavy adhesive like tear and tape when you're making a box. Using snail adhesive just doesn't hold things together permanently. It will for a short time, but then it ends up pulling apart. So you always want to make sure that you use really strong adhesives when putting together boxes or anything where the paper is going to have tension on it. So I'm removing the backing here, and then I'm going to fold these pieces in and fold this box together, and then you've just got this cute little box. Now you could obviously decorate this a million ways. The sky's the limit. There's no end in sight for what you could do with a little box like this, but we are going to use the tag from the die set to kind of create a bag box, maybe. Maybe that's what I should have called this. So you've got your two tags. You're going to score on the tag end at a half inch or 1.3 centimeters. And then again at 1.5 inches or 3.8 centimeters. And you're going to do that on both tags. And then you're going to be able to adhere these to the box, and then it will give you a little bit of a like bag or box with the topper. I don't know. And you saw that cute koala bear paper there. FYI, the dies from the Bonanza Buddies set cut out the animals in the designer series paper. So cute and so smart of Stampin' Up, because that makes everything so easy. Okay, so here, I don't know what I was thinking. I was thinking in my head, if I tie these together at the top, it'll keep them together while I try to adhere them to the box. I don't know. I made this whole situation much more complicated than it needed to be. So my suggestion to you is to just adhere them to the box and don't be stressed out. The tip for adhering to the box, though, is don't use snail like I'm doing right here, because I realized very quickly that's not going to work. Use the multi-purpose glue. This is like my new best friend. I've been using multi-purpose glue a ton lately. So the thing about multi-purpose glue is that it's movable after you put something down. So I'm able to still scooch the items around. And for whatever reason, this glue does not make paper buckle. You know how like Elmer's glue makes paper all wonky and buckly? This glue does not do that. So it works fantastic. It adheres really well. And when you first put it in place, you can still kind of maneuver things around to get them to fit correctly. And then it glues really strong. So I love it. I've been using it so much more lately, and I don't know why I haven't used it more before this. So now I'm using Stampin' Dimensionals to add this little whisper white circle to the box. This is the one that we punched in the beginning. And then we're gonna add our little koala bear to the front of the box, and then a few other embellishments. So while we're doing that, I just wanted to tell you that first of all you're going to see from me on my videos from now until January 3rd are going to be brand new product videos. So I am basically doing a countdown to the new catalog. There are so many things in the new catalog that I love that I'm done with Christmas. I'm over it. I'm past it. And I'm going to start making new projects. Now, this goes against most people's philosophies in that, you know, you can't buy this stuff yet. But I don't care. The way I feel about it is I am just having fun making stuff with all the new products. And we're past Christmas. You can't make Christmas projects now. I mean, you can. If you wanted to sit down and bust out a few Christmas projects, you totally could. But most people by now kind of are on the downward spiral of all of that, or they already know what they're making. So I thought, you know what, we're just going to go fresh and new, and we're going to use new products from now until January 3rd so that you can have a really good idea of what it is that you want to buy out of the mini catalog, or maybe you want to purchase the starter kit and you want to get free products when the new catalog comes out. So then you need to make a list of the things that you really love. You'll be able to choose $125 in product. You just pay $99, and then you get some free extra goodies during celebration when you join during that time. Okay, so two Hershey Nuggets fit in here perfectly. I tried to fit that gum in there, but it didn't fit, and that's okay. So here's our little bag, and then I'm just going to use the Daffodil Delight ruched ribbon on the top and tie it with some twine, because I thought that would look really, really cute. Okay, a short, quick story time, because we're already almost out of time here. I just wanted to update you guys on Truby, because some people have asked. She never did get sick. the bubblegum must have digested and come out somewhere at some point, but I didn't go inspect because it's raining and gross here. And frankly, it's not something I want to do. So she's fine. She's acting totally normal. So tomorrow she's having a little surgery to get a bump removed from her ear. And she should be right as rain by Wednesday. And then what else is happening? I don't know. That's it. I'm going to spend the week making beautiful projects and yeah, just having fun with all this new stuff, all the new products. They're so fun. I will be getting my pre-orders. Those will be showing up, which is really exciting. I've ordered more stuff during that free shipping sale we had last week. Oh my Lord, that was amazing. And so I definitely spent a fair amount of money. Let's put it that way. Because free shipping. I mean, why wouldn't I? All right. So, of course, because I'm trying to tie a bow on camera, I'm really struggling. My nails are way too long. I'm getting those taken care of this weekend, which you're still going to see. It's so weird because when I'm recording videos with you, a lot of times, like, my nails are different when I'm actually doing the voiceover and getting the video out to you because I have to do things in advance. So it's kind of a little bizarre thing. It's interesting to me. Anyway, I'm trimming this up and it's done. That's the finished product. Isn't it adorable? So stinking cute to give to somebody for their birthday. All right. Thanks for tuning in. If you want to watch any other videos from me, you can click them here. Shop with me at shoploveandstampin.com. Click on that circle with my face in it to subscribe to my channel. And don't forget, you have a few days left to sign up for my Love and Stampin' Monthly Club. And you can still sign up for the paper share that I have going. Links below. Bye-bye.